Good for sitting in for me if I'm setting up like a vlog or a video or something and doing it by myself. I just set the avocado into frame where I'm gonna be. It's pretty good for checking like
it's
focus.
Good for and yeah, stuff, like where
which
you're
is
gonna
why
be
it's
at.
Back there right now.
I love it so much. Yeah. I always think of avocado.
It's pretty. Thanks. It's pretty comfy.
Have you seen that little?
Oh,
meme?
The little camera's like opening up the Christmas present. Is so
an
excited.
Avocado. Thanks.
Oh, so cute. So cute.
Well, then.
Well, then. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
Hey, Gallifrey pals. welcome to the Gallifrey Gals Get Warped.
Warped.
That's the show where we watch Star Trek The Next Generation. My name's Paula.
I'm Katrina.
And
this show is so fucking good.
It is. You can see why. I was like, I want to show you this show.
Yeah, it's so fucking good. It's like a very good show.
It's great.
I talk about it all the time now. I'm definitely a Star Trek nerd.
Yes, we've done it, everyone.
So there we are, and we've only watched the first episode of the fifth season, which was really good, and we've got Worf back.
We do have Worf back, yay!
I knew it wouldn't last long.
A civil war averted for the, or a Romulan war, rather,
a Romulan,
averted.
Yeah.
The civil war is already happening.
Civil war is already current. Very good episode. The daughter of Tasha Yar. What's her name again?
It is Sela.
Sela. We'll see her again, I assume. I don't know. I guess we'll find out.
Who knows?
Who knows? All right. What's this episode called?
This episode, the second episode of season 5, is called Darmok.
Darmok.
Mm-hmm.
This seems like more Romulan stuff, but I guess we'll see.
Guess we will see. And that's all I will say. There is I'll prep you. There is an actor in this episode who I think you will recognize. We'll find it out. There is a piece of wardrobe Picard gets that is the first time we see it in the show, and I will point that out when it happens.
Cool. And the actor, would I recognize him from Star Trek or just in general?
I will tell you it is a woman. And it would be just in general.
Okay. Cool.
We'll see, though. We'll see. There might be a generational thing at play here, but we'll see if you recognize
find out.
Her when you see her. Okay. And that's all I'll say.
Okay.
And I don't think that counts as spoilers. So
I don't think it does either.
They don't.
Guess who makes the rules?
Like plot points, they're just we like trivia. Do. Yeah, we make the rules, so.
Enterprise is en route to the uninhabited Eladrell system. It's
Eladrell.
Near the territory occupied by an enigmatic race known as the Children of Tama.
The Children of Tama.
Arrived at Eladrell 4 nearly 3.
Is it the jacket?
Yes, it's the motorcycle jacket.
I fucking want that. The signal is a standard. What the fuck? That's so good.
It does not carry.
Sorry, that was really loud, but that's really good.
Pretty awesome.
Starfleet believes. Oh my god, he looks like such a baddie.
Commander. Federation vessels have encountered tomorrow.
I already thought Picard was good looking, and now it's like.
The meeting went without incident. Rye and Jim.
Oh no, this is literally their.
It's their incomprehensible.
I sense nothing but good intentions from them, Captain.
Oh, fuck.
Mr. Data. The Temarian seems to be stating the proper names of individuals and locations. Yes, but what does it all mean? I am at a...
Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra.
Ah!
Block their transporter shields, extend to maximum range.
Not enough time.
Body snatched!
Tamarians have transported Captain Picard to the planet's surface along with their own captain.
When the walls.
What if he wants to, like. I don't know. What if it's like a blood oath? Yeah, okay, if that's not fucking creepy. Follow him? Question mark.
Marion are in apparent good health.
When the walls... Did his fire burn out? Picard, you had it.
What now, Captain? You attack me in my sleep?
Timber.
What does that mean? Fire. Does timber mean fire?
He's like, I don't know what fire timber. Is.
His arms wide.
Timber is a person. His arms wide because he's holding them apart in generosity, in giving. Thank you. Thank you.
But I can barely read you, Commander.
McDonald, maintain communication as long as conditions permit.
Commander, I am reading a power surge in the Tamari.
Deanna stood up like,
Lieutenant Worm.
Yeah.
Evasive maneuver sequence Delta. Maneuver sequence Delta.
They called your bluff.
I may be able to land, but I will not be able to take off.
Understood.
It's like a warning shot. Oh, Worf is pissed.
God, I wanted to go!
Enough to turn them back, but not enough to hurt them.
Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra!
I was curious. I'm in Doha.
Saka! Timber! His arms were timber!
I don't think he wants to fight.
I'm gonna fight you. You will just have...
He doesn't want to fight. His arms wide.
Yeah, Timber. Right? He's like, remember the last time I said this to you?
The fucking knife.
I'll go along with that.
Not good enough.
That transporter.
2 hours.
You can't, Riker.
Maybe three.
I want the captain.
You can't interrupt this. Well, too
That's
bad.
Not
it's
very
the
likely,
truth.
Sir.
I don't want to hear that, Commander.
Well, I'm worried they're going to take him out before.
That's how you communicate, isn't it? By citing example. By metaphor. Ozani's army with fist open.
Sukat, his eyes uncovered.
Oh, no! No! Put me back now.
When the walls fell.
Are you fucking kidding me?
You used the words Temba, his arms wide, when you gave me the knife and the fire. Could that mean give? Temba, his arms wide. Darmok. Give me more about Darmok.
Darmok.
This would not be my strong suit.
It's very tricky.
He went to the same island as Darmok. Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra. They struggled together against a common foe, the beast at Tanagra. Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra.
It's a split. Darmok
and Jalad on the ocean.
They left together.
Oh.
You knew there was a dangerous creature on this planet, and you knew from the tale of Darmok that a danger shared might sometimes bring two people together. Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra. They became great friends. Gilgamesh and Enkidu at Uruk. I understand your sacrifice, Captain.
We got him, Commander.
Maximum shields.
Aye, sir.
No!
Red alert! Starboard shield's holding at 52%.
Commander, we cannot survive another hit.
Hail the Tamarian vessel.
His face black, his eyes red.
Tamak. The river Tamak. In winter.
Darmok.
And Jalad. At Tanagra.
So Kat, his eyes open.
The beast of Tanagra. Uzani, his army. Shaka, when the walls fell.
Picard and Dathan at Eladril.
And they're off.
Marab with sails unfurled.
Power has been restored, sir.
But at least they're not new enemies. More familiarity with our own mythology might help us to relate to theirs. Tamarian was willing to risk all.
Just like to connect.
Just for the hope of communication. Connection. Now the door is open between our peoples.
Captain Kirk will never stand up to Captain Picard. Ever. No offense, TOS fans. I enjoy watching TOS, but like...
It's just different. It's different.
No one will ever be Captain Picard.
Yeah, I agree with you. Now, I've seen more of the captains.
Yeah, you've seen more. I could speak for myself already. I already know. No one will ever compare to him. It's just the story of connection, and we're all so desperate for it, you know, like deep down we're all just so desperate for connection. And it's so much harder when we can't have it because of miscommunication, or you know, the inability to understand one another, and that can be really scary for people like Riker, who's you know, just trying to do his job, and he's fearing for his captain, and I totally understand that. It's just in the moment emotionally it's frustrating because we see what's happening on the other side.
We know of it. It's the dramatic irony of we know what the character does.
We know what's happening, and Riker didn't, and he was just doing what he knew, which is there's a danger, and so it's based out of fear.
They aren't acting in a way that feels helpful, so we have to do something. Yeah,
you know, difference in culture and difference in how one approaches a situation. It's like, you know, Picard said that he was willing to sacrifice not only himself but all of them just in hopes that they could understand one another.
They knew, you know, the other ship knew what their captain was intending to do, and the Enterprise didn't know what the intention was and didn't know.
And again, if there is any one fucking person to like be put in a situation like that, it's Captain Picard. Because like in the beginning, was he confused and a little like there was fear there? Absolutely. You know, he's like, I don't want to fight you. I'm not doing this. I don't want to, you know, but his patience and his willingness to just listen is just so fucking huge, and just such a huge lesson for anybody in life. Just stop and listen.
He has the curious heart of a true explorer. Yes.
He wants to understand.
He wants to understand, and that leads him in everything he does and his approach to everything he does. And I think that sets him apart from other captains and other characters in the Star Trek franchise, personally.
It's just in such a genuine value. Like, there's just, you know, it's like him with the Klingons. It's not, oh yeah, Picard's involved with the Klingons. Like, no, he knows how to speak their language. He knows their culture.
He's an anthropologist, basically. Yeah.
Yes, like, he understands, you know, like, he doesn't take these things lightly. It's just at the end there, that little moment. He took that moment. No one was watching. No one's there with him. He's taking that moment to respect their culture, honor their captain who sacrificed himself for what just happened. And, like, that's just so fucking beautiful. What a good episode.
And I'm waiting for us to get to this one. I really love this one. I think it's beautiful. Yeah. And it's, you'll hear people in the fandom, if you will quote this episode, Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra. And, you know, that is, it is, there are a lot of things from this because it's the same phrases over and over again that people will quote. So you'll see it on, like, t-shirts and stuff like that. So I'm glad that you can now, like, understand what it is. I'm it was excited to realize this was early in this season, because I really love this one, and I've been waiting for us to get to it.
It really sets a tone, you know. It was really very good. I'm not gonna lie, I didn't even pay attention to whatever female.
I knew you didn't catch her, and that it's completely fine, especially in the middle of everything
else. I was too engulfed. I was too engulfed.
Yeah. So Lieutenant Leffler, who was the engineering lieutenant, who
Leffler. Okay.
That's Ashley Judd. Young Ashley Judd.
Wow. I didn't even pay attention. Okay. Didn't even fucking
in the
catch
moment,
it.
And I didn't point it out because I was like, we're in the middle of a moment and we're going to, this will take us out of it. But yeah, then a young Ashley Judd there.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That was a very, 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 very good episode.
Yeah. Apparently this particular idea, this story was in development for the show for like 2 years before they finally settled on like a version of the script they wanted to produce. So it, cause it went through a lot of different like versions of like
what is the goal here? What is the through line? You know,
like even like what is the, cause they knew like, oh, we want it to be where they can't interpret the other person's language and how do they figure it out? But beyond that, like what shape that took changed quite a bit until they finally settled on kind of using the inspiration of Gilgamesh, of that story to what if we model it off of that story? And so that's kind of what they settled on and what they did. So, yeah.
That's just so, wow.
Yeah, I really love this one. So, yeah.
Really love it. It's just very, very good. Very, very good. Dynamic.
And, oh, man, the alien design, I think, was so good.
So fascinating. The nostrils, when he hurt his head, the slit in it. It was so interesting. Really very good. I just, wow. Wow, 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 wow. I fucking love Star Trek.
Yeah.
I love this goddamn show. It's I was just saying it the other day on TikTok Live, like, I cannot believe I've never seen this, but I am so fucking grateful I haven't, because it feels weirdly special to get to do it now. Thanks for being here, y'all. Here we are. We're in season 5 of Star Trek The Next Generation. Wow. You guys have been here for a while.
I was like, look, we don't have to commit to watching all 7 seasons. Let's just watch like at least the first 2 and then see how you feel.
And I'm like, more, 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 more. Wow. Thanks for being here. I feel like this is going to be a hard one to edit for YouTube because there was a lot of silence.
Yeah.
I will do my best with it. So I hope this doesn't get blocked, but check it out on Patreon so you can catch the full length reaction to this one. It's a good one, y'all. And, you know, support us financially. It helps a lot, and it's what helps us continue to literally do this channel. Yes, so we appreciate you all so much.
We do.
And Shepard does too. Can you hear him in the background singing to you?
Let me in.
Mom, what did you do?
Mom, I'm on the other side of a closed door. I hate it.
I feel left out. Oh, well, thanks, y'all.
Thank again,
subscribe, like, comment. You know.
Pew, pew, pew. And catch your gals for gals next time as we boldly watch what no noob has ever watched before.
Dice me.
That's KATRINA.
Bye-bye.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you liked this video, go ahead and give it a little thumbs up. And if you want to be notified when we post new content, go ahead and subscribe to our channel and hit that little bell in the corner.